Hello, my dear students. Let's continue with the further concepts from the list chapter. But before that, let us recall the things that we have discussed in the previous video. So, in the previous video, we have started with the tuples, the data structure tuples and the strings. And we have also compared the tuples and strings with the list over there. So, if you remember, I already told you what is the basic difference between the tuple and the list. Though this seems to be same, there are the two important differences that you can find out. So the one thing is with the way how the tuple is created and the way how the list is created. So the tuples are created with the round parenthesis, whereas the lists are created with the square brackets. So in this case, though the creation is different with respect to the tuple or the list, the accessing the elements or applying the slicing concepts both on the list as well as the tuples is going to remain same. And the most important difference over here is with the mutable and the immutable data type. Whereas the list is considered as a mutable data type and the tuples are considered as the immutable data type. So if you have watched my previous video, I clearly explained you what is the difference between the mutable data type and the immutable data type. If you are able to change the already added content to the any of the data type, then it is said to be as the mutable, which is concerned with the list over there. But in tuples, if you have added some of the elements and if you are going to change the any element where you want to replace the one element with the new content over there, so which is not allowed for the tuple. So if you try to do so, you can see here in this example, so already the 42 is at the ones position, and in the next statement you are trying to replace that 42 with the new element over here. So this is not supported for the tuple data type. So you can see here X is a tuple data type. It is not supported. The replacement of the already the added element is not supported in the tuple. So you can see if you try to do so, you are getting the error as tuple object does not support the item assigned. So this is the reason why the tuple is considered to be as an immutable data type. Whereas the same thing if you try to do with the list, it is going to allow for that. So that's the reason why the list is considered to be as an mutable data type. We have also seen that how we can convert the list to the tuple or the tuple to the list, which is said to be as a type conversion with respect to the list and the tuple. So here are the examples that I have already discussed in the previous video. And now coming to the next concept, that is the references. So we'll try to see what happens if we are going to change the content that has been added to the normal variable and what happens if we are going to add or change the content with respect to the list here. So let's concentrate on this first example here. So in this example, you can see here, the spam is a variable where you have added the value as a 42. That means the 42 has been stored into the variable spam. So in this case, you can say that the spam is an integer data type where it contains the value as a 42. In the next statement, what we have done, we have taken the another new variable. Here we have just copied the variable spam to the cheese. The new variable is cheese. So in this case, what does it mean? The cheese also contains 42, whereas the spam also contains the 42. That means the content of the spam has been purely copied to the new variable cheese. Now what we are going to do next, we are changing the value of the spam here. Earlier it was 42, now we are changing it to the new value as the 100 here. So try to print both the variables here. Now we can see that whether the content has been copied or not. So if you try to print the spam, you will get the new value. Why? Because the new value is going to replace the already added content here. So that's the reason why you are counting the 100, why you are getting the result as a 100 here. So in the next case, you can see the cheese, try to print the cheese which contains the original value which has been copied into earlier by the spam variable. So what I mean to say here with this example is, so if you take a normal variable, so once you initialize it to the one value and if you copy that to the new variable, so the contents whatever are there into the variable will be copied or be duplicated into the new variable. So let's see if we do the same thing with the list, how does it is going to make the difference here, or else what difference lies with the list here. So in this case you can see here the same variable name has been taken spam, where we have added the values by taking the help of the square brackets. That means the spam now is considered as a list variable. So in this case it was just an integer variable, but since you have added the list contents to this variable, the spam is now considered as a list variable. So in the next case, what we have done, the same thing we have done here. So the earlier also we tried to copy here, so here also we are taking the new variable where we are just copying the spam to this new variable cheese. But what are the mistake, what does the difference it is going to do here, we'll see it. So in the next immediate statement, what we are trying to do, the cheese of 1, that is we are, and then one, the index value with 1 needs to be replaced with the hello here with respect to the cheese variable. See, if we have copied the spam to the cheese, that means the cheese, spam being a list variable, now cheese is also going to be considered as a list variable. So cheese of 1, in the sense 01, this part has to be replaced with this new value here as a hello. So after you do that, you just try to print both the both the variables here and observe what output you are going to get in the both the cases. See, we have not changed anything with respect to the spam variable here. We have just changed with respect to the cheese variable name. So in this case, if you try to print the spam, you can see here we are getting the value as a 0 and 1 has been replaced as a hello, 2, 3, 4 and 5. If you try to print the cheese, for that also you are getting the same result here. So what difference you can observe with this example and this example here, even though you have not changed anything with the spam, though you have changed with respect to the cheese variable, it has reflected to even for the spam variable also. Why is that so? Why? Because you do remember here, whenever you do copy between two list variables, you are not actually duplicating the values here. Instead, the values what has been added as a list is given a reference ID, so which is going to be pointing to the both the variables here. In that case, whenever you change the any content to the any of these two variables, it will be reflected to the both the variable names. So is it confusing? Let's see with an figure. So in the first case, where you have created the spam variable, added the list content, for the reason it is considered as a list variable here. So you can see a spam in the on the box, you can see the spam. So what does it contains? It actually doesn't contain the actual elements that you have created in this list. Instead, this list will be stored into the memory location for which it has given the ID reference as this number. So this is going to be stored into this spam. The ID is going to be referred here. So in the next case, where you are going to create the another variable as a cheese, where you are going to copy it to the spam. So here it seems to be copying, but actually it is not going to duplicate the values and going to store into the new variable as a cheese. Instead, whatever the list that has been earlier created for the spam, the same ID reference is going to be pointing to the cheese variable now. So now you, with this figure, you can see here, you have a list created here, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 being the list elements which has the ID reference. So the same ID reference is going to be allocated for both the cheese as well as the spam. Right. So in the next case, where you actually change the content of the cheese with this part. So this box where it has the title as a cheese, if you take this variable name and with the index value 1 to be replaced with the hello here. So it is not going to do it only this part here. Instead, you can see a cheese is also going to point to this reference ID where this 1 is going to be replaced with the hello here. But this is done with the actual contents of the list where both the variables are referenced here. Even the spam is going to reference to the same reference ID, whereas the cheese is also going to reference to the same reference ID. So that means whenever you do any changes to this contents, the original contents of the list will be changed, which will be reflected to the both the variables where you have copied it, spam and the cheese. So all these cases are going to be with respect to the list. But whereas it is going to make a difference for the normal variables, where actual contents are going to be duplicated between the two copied variables. But in the list, it is going to do in this way. Right. So if it's here, Python uses the references whenever the variables must store the values of mutable data types, such as list or the dictionaries. For the values of immutable data types such as the strings, integers or the tuples, Python variables will store the value itself. I hope you got the difference here. So what they are trying to say that in Python, these are the references are going to be used only for the data types which are mutable. So the list is a mutable data type. The another one data type which is mutable is a dictionary, which we are going to discuss in the further concepts. For these two data types which are mutable, the references are going to be used. Instead duplicating the values, only the references are going to be used. But whereas in the cases, the variables which are the immutable, for example, it may be the strings, it may be the integer variable, it may be the tuple variable, for which where you cannot replace the contents, for that, whenever you do the copying between the two variables, the duplicating of values is going to be taken over there. So, do remember this thing. So, you might be asked to explain the references, or else you can see the where do the references IDs are be used with respect to the data types in the Python. Or else one more kind of the expected question is, references IDs are used only with respect to the list and the dictionaries justified. So, for this reason, for this thing, first you need to understand the immutable and the mutable data types, based upon which you can explain how does the list and the dictionaries are going to be how does the list and dictionaries are going to be using the references IDs, and why does it is not applicable for the strings, integers or the tuples. I hope this part is clear to you here. So in the previous concept where we have seen the references IDs are going to be used when you try to copy between the two list variables. Right. So in this case, in some of the scenarios, you might want actually to duplicate the values to be stored into the new variable, new list variable. So in that case, how you can do is, you can do even that also by using the module copy. And for the function of this copy, the methods from this copy modules are the copy and the deep copy. So this is going to allow you to actually duplicate the values from the list where you can store it into the new list variables. So let us see how we can do it. Although passing around the references is often the handiest way to deal with the list and the dictionaries. If the function modifies the list or dictionary that is passed, you may not want these changes in the original list or the dictionary value. So when you require such things is, for example, here you can see the both the variables are referring to the same content, but if you try to do changes with any one variable, it will be reflected to the original content. So if you do not want such things to happen, in that case you can go for using the copy module. So for this reason, Python provides a module named copy that provides both the copy method and the deep copy method functions. So the copy method, we'll see how we can use the copy method here. So here is an example you can see. First thing is you need to import the module with the name copy. So next you can take the any list variable with the specific contents here. So in the next case you can see this is the variable, the new variable where you want to duplicate the values of the this spam list variable. So in this case how you can do is cheese is equal to this part is the name of the module, this one. Name of the module that is copy dot followed by the name of the method. See, do not get confused with the two copies here. The first copy is the name of the module dot followed by the name of the method that you want to use here, copy. So from which list variable you want to copy, the name of the variable is being the parameter to this method here, spam. So here you can see now you change the content of the cheese and check out whether it has been reflected in the original list variable or not. In this case, the cheese of 1 is 42. So earlier what it is, the spam of 1 is B. So this you want to change it to the 42, but with respect to this cheese variable. Now you try to print both the variables. You'll get to know whether it has reflected to the original contents or not. So now you try to print spam, which is the original list variable here. So if you print so, you'll get the ABCD, the original contents as it is. Now try to print the new variable where you have duplicated the values of the spam, cheese, where you have even changed the one of the content. So try to print the cheese here. Now you will get the values as A and B being replaced with a 42, C and D. So with this example, you can observe the difference here. By using the copy module and the copy method, you are able to just duplicate the values and store into the new variable. And if you do any changes with respect to the new variable, it is not going to be reflected to the original contents of the list. So this is how you can utilize the copy module and the copy method to duplicate the values even of the list contents. This is how it is done. With the help of a figure here, it has been explained. So originally you have created the spam variable where you have added the contents as a A, B, C, D, so which will be given with a certain ID letters. The next case, what you have done, you have duplicated or you have taken a new variable where you have applied the copy method and the copy module with respect to the spam. That means this is going to entirely create the new reference ID itself. So you can see here the reference ID of the spam variable is 5720 followed by the 45s. So when you have applied the copy module and the copy method, the cheese is not going to refer to this ID reference. Instead, a new variable will be created with a new ID reference. So you can just observe the difference between the IDs here. But to this, the contents of this will be copied over here. The values will be duplicated. So this is how it is going to make difference. For example, if you change the any content of this cheese variable, so it is referring to the entirely different ID over here. So that means any changes to this content will not be reflected over here. So whenever you want to duplicate the values of the list, you can go for using the copy module and the copy method. So sometimes what happens, the elements of the list is going to be the list itself, and when you want to copy even that also, at that time you can go for using the deep copy. So this is the end of the list chapter. So in the further video, I'll discuss some of the assignments or the projects that has been given at the end of this chapter. So I genuinely ask you to go through the all the videos of this chapter. So which is where you are going to face the internals. So the syllabus of your internals are going to be till the videos whatever I'm going to cover up to the Saturday, right? So whatever the doubts that you have, you just make a list of it. We shall discuss those doubts in the interaction.